What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, y'all, we knew the left was low. We knew they would stoop low enough to delete and unalive babies. We know their issues. We know their proclivities. We know what they promote. But maybe some of y'all didn't realize how low they would actually go to cannibalize upon their own. Y'all, I came across this video where Charlamagne the God from the Breakfast Club is taking incoming fire from his own people, from the left, y'all, because he dared to step out here on Beyonce's internet and criticize Plies of all people. Is that what y'all rocking with? You rocking with Plies? Is that who leading your movement? Y'all following behind Plies? Is that where it's at? Is that the standard for the blackity blacks now? The crunchity, crispity, crackity blacks? Is that what y'all own? To the point that you would eat your own for going against somebody like a Plies? Well, y'all, I guess Charlamagne messed around and found out. Because he came against this video that Plies recently put out where he was scolding the community for disagreeing with Kamala Harris. Boy, seemed like he got some instant blowback from the blackity blacks who has something to say about his disagreement with Plies. Y'all check this out.
But to everybody who, especially the ones who look like me, and the men who look like me, who quit the, if Kamala want my vote, she need to explain herself to me what she gonna do for the black people. Listen, stop asking a black woman to explain herself to you or explain herself to y'all. If y'all ain't willing to ask a white man to explain himself, y'all cool with the white man not explaining his self to you. But the mother black, she need to explain herself to me what she gonna do for the black community. She want my vote, she need to explain herself. You ain't motherfucking the white man explain herself. You too motherfucking scared to ask him. Somebody need to explain something to y'all. Well, she been in the office already 3.5 years. Why she ain't do all the things she said she was gonna do? Cause she ain't the president, that's why.
Plies is absolutely positively wrong. If people are asking questions, that's great. I don't even know why Plies is making this a black woman versus black man thing. This isn't about black men and black women. It's about elected officials and potential voters. The whole point of campaign season is for candidates to go out there and explain to the American people why they should be the one in charge of this country. Votes are earned, not given. And they are earned through you going out there and explaining yourself. Vice President Kamala Harris has to go out there and explain her agenda and why she's the person for the job. Former President Donald Trump has to go out there and explain his agenda and why he should be the person to get his job again, you know, or get the job again. I don't understand Plies or any black person, for that matter, telling black people to just settle. Just accept whatever the candidate is giving you. Don't ask any questions.
Yeah, but
just
they've been
vote.
Doing it. They
don't have to explain anything to us.
They've been doing it for a long time. Even with Biden, when we ask questions to Biden, well, it's the best of two evils. You know what I mean? You got to pick one. But no, if you have questions, people should be able to ask. Listen, that's the point of a politician, right? They're supposed to represent us, represent our district, represent our country. Shouldn't we ask?
Forget. And by the way, they should be explaining without us asking. Mm-hmm. That's the whole point of them doing these press conferences and these meetings.
Yeah.
The same way these politicians have meetings for their donors and they have rallies and press conferences explaining themselves and their agendas to certain groups, they should have to explain themselves to black people the same way. Plies is 1,000,000,000% wrong.
We are 72 days away from November 5th, right? Charlamagne Tha God, Jermaine Dupri, this is what you're doing. This is what I want you to do. Let's chit chat. I promise you, I will never understand the addiction to being intentionally ignorant. Please, let's talk about what we know. On July 21st, Joe Biden dropped out of the race for president, meaning that Kamala Harris joined the presidential race with only 113 days until Election Day. Some of y'all don't understand how the three branches of government work, so please let me explain to you why her entering the race with only 113 days to win an election is really unheard of. During Donald Trump's 2016 run for presidency, he launched his campaign 513 days before Election Day. 2008, Obama launched his campaign 635
3 days before Election Day. The year 2000, George W. Bush launched his campaign 514 days before the election, and Al Gore launched his campaign 501 days before the election. And in all of that, inside of those 113 days, the Harris-Walz campaign has broken a myriad of records. They are doing the work. They are laying out their plan, rallying behind this amazing campaign that is truly running against not just Donald Trump, but Project 2025. Certain Black men have decided to use their platforms to create divisiveness. As Plies pointed out, there is a huge difference between wanting to know your candidate's strategy for the first 100 days in office, what they are going to do for you, and holding them to a standard that you don't hold politicians who are not of color. You have Charlamagne the guy. Now, did Plies lace his point with a bunch of MFers? Absolutely. Did he lay it out eloquently? Also, absolutely. So for Charlamagne the God's takeaway from Plies to be that Plies is telling Black people to just take any candidate that's given to them and to settle is truly, well, willfully.
How you do whatever you want to do with your vote. But I'm not voting for no mother rich white man to be able to do whatever the f- you want to do. I'm just not doing it. I don't hate women that much. And I damn sure don't hate a Black woman that much. So you can vote for a mother AK, or you can vote for the mother KKK. You can vote for whatever K you want a mother vote for. That's your motherfucking business. Ah, she don't ever talk about her pot. Yes, she must. You just don't want a mother here. That lady told you she trying to get $25,000 trying to buy a home. Trying to build three more mother million homes. Trying to lower the drug prices for everybody, not just the elderly. Trying to get tax cut to the middle motherfucker. That lady trying to... No tax on tips or whatever the hell it is. That lady telling you what she trying to mother. You just don't want a mother.
Here's the thing. I don't have a problem with people saying that Kamala Harris needs to earn their vote. Saying that these are my policy priorities and I need to hear about where she stands on these things. What I do have a problem with is when you're informed about those things and then you still want to stand 10 toes down. Oh, your if you just don't like to say that, I absolutely do have an issue with the notion that she doesn't have policies, that she hasn't discussed policies. And I have an issue with people who have perpetuated that narrative and how people have platformed people for the sole purpose of causing confusion and chaos when they have the ability to platform people that can give people the information. Are we just going to wallow in the, well, people are saying that she ain't got no policies. Well, people don't know where she stands. Or are we going to do something about it? On my show, when you say you want to hear something, guess what? I got the receipts. I don't just let people who don't have the information lead my ass along and we all just acting confused like we don't know the half a damn. But others choose to do otherwise. So there's a very clear reason why more people don't know about what VP is doing. It's not because she hasn't said it enough. No, she didn't call you personally and say, hey, girl, did you hear about my insulin proposal? It's because there's more profit in platforming and perpetuating negativity and confusion than there is in educating people. And be clear, it's not just people who are anti-Kamala that don't want to platform certain people. It's people who are pro-Kamala, too, that don't want to pass the mic. Catch that.
And there you have it, y'all. Do not leave this video without leaving a comment and let me know what you think about this, because the left is so upset. They are so mad. They are so perturbed that they are shooting at Charlamagne for disagreeing with Plies and stating facts. Y'all just gonna hide this woman till election day? This woman got 3.5 years of experience of on-the-job training. She's second in command to the United States of America. If Joe Biden is demented and he can't function no more and he just got to go to sleep on the beach, well, sis, you next in line. Step up and do the job. Y'all, who run in the White House if she can't step up and do the job? Make sure you leave a comment and let me know your answer to that question, because I want to know who's flying the plane. Who's supposed to land the plane, y'all? That plane that we all sitting on, that plane we all riding on, who do you expect to land it if the second in command is somewhere in hiding? This is a rare occasion, y'all, where I agree with Charlamagne. Y'all, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share the video so we can all get more people involved in the conversation. Like I always say, y'all, Always remember and never forget. Without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.